Hi, my name is Parker Braaten. I'm a second year student at Northern Arizona University, and I'm currently enrolled in the construction management program. This summer, I was given the amazing opportunity to intern for the plants division at Granite Construction. In this video, I will guide you through, step by step, how asphalt is made. Thank you.
We start at our aggregate plant in Little Rock, California. Here, material is dug from the ground and pushed into the primary crusher, or jaw crusher. The material, once crushed to adequate size, is sent down half a mile's length of conveyor belt to the surge pile. The material is then fed into the surge's internal hopper, otherwise known as a pan feeder. From there, the material goes through its first screen, sifting and sorting the sand from the coarse and oversized aggregate. As the primary screen is sorting material, the natural fines are conveyed to a hopper where it is then washed and screened. Meanwhile, the coarse and oversized aggregate is sent into the secondary crusher for size reduction. After the aggregates have gone through the secondary crusher, they are sent into the secondary screen. There, the ags are diverted into two different screens. 3/4 inch and 1/2 inch rock will be sent straight to their respective piles. Anything larger will be sorted, sifted, and sent back to be further reduced. All rejected aggregate that came from screen number 2 is fed into the tertiary crusher and then sent back to be screened once more. Once the rock is of adequate size, it is fed into another conveyor belt for further processing. At this point, all aggregate is sent into the tertiary screen so that the 3/8 inch rock can be separated from the rock dust. Once screened, the 3/8 inch ag and rock dust are fed into the hoppers, which feed the pile conveyors. Now that we have our natural fines, 3/4, 1/2, 3/8, and rock dust in piles, we move on to our washing system. Aggregates, dust, and concrete sand are sent to the wash screen to be sprayed and sorted. From here, the concrete sand will flow through the single screw washer using reclaimed water from our wash pond. Dirty water is sent into the settling pond, where gravity pulls the dirt to the bottom, keeping fresh water at the top. The other products of the wash screen, pea gravel and chad, are also sent into piles. Now we move on to the hot plant, located in Santa Paula, California. Once all of the material and aggregates are to their appropriate sizes, 3/4, 1/2, 3/8, sand, and dust are loaded into their cold feed bin. Material then flows through a hopper onto a variable speed conveyor belt. This allows for accurate percentages of each type of material, specific to customer mix design specification. Aggregates are then sent into a shaker for consistency, rejecting any non-conforming material. It is then sent into the drum. The drum has a few functions. The first function is so that the material can be heated up to at least 350 degrees, ridding all unnecessary moisture. The second is particulate filtration. The baghouse is designed to catch any particulate harmful to the environment, separating dust from gases. The third function of the drum is mixing. Another integral part of asphalt production is RAP, recycled asphalt product. The RAP is loaded into cold feed bins to be measured and then mixed into the drum with the aggregate. While everything is heating up, hot virgin oil binder is sprayed into the drum, thus producing asphalt. Once the asphalt is fully combined, it is sent to the drag slab. Now, the trucks will arrive to prepare for their asphalt. They start by spraying a coating of oil in their truck beds. This helps prevent the asphalt from sticking. After the asphalt has been loaded and stored into the silos, the truck drives onto the scale for displacement measuring. Asphalt is released from the silos into the trucks in varying capacity. Now for the final stage of asphalt. The old asphalt is ground up and fed into a truck to be recycled. After that, the digouts are swept until clean. Then, tack, an oil coating used to bind the asphalt to the ground surface, is sprayed. Bottom dump trucks then make their way along the pre-tacked surface with fresh asphalt. The paver then follows the truck, picking up the asphalt with small paddles, throwing it into a hopper, which evenly distributes the material to the specified width. The screed then levels out the asphalt to a predetermined height. Following the paver is the paving crew. They are responsible for the little details that the screed did not fill or get. And to finish it off, the knockdown roller comes and compacts the asphalt to roughly 80%. The finished rollers after the primary are there to do any final ironing and compaction. And there you have it, a start to finish of how asphalt is made.